Only grace around me, get it OG. And it's cold blooded, nigga GP. Team Rockman winning, nigga Team 3. Niggas just wanna go
viral. Niggas don't wanna. What's up, y'all? It's your boy, GB, gold-blooded in the building. I'm digging through the crates a little bit. And I got a lot of content over the years, so I'm going to keep bringing y'all hits and hits and hits. Today, we're going to talk about the person that bring boxing to the zone, baby. If you didn't get that 99 pack, go get that 99 pack. Just drop the 99 and get the whole thing for the whole year, because that's the best, get the best bang for your buck right there. You get all the zone content for $99 a year. Y'all make sure y'all go get that. Eddie Hearn, I interviewed Eddie Hearn. This was back in 2019. This was the biggest card that was brought to Saudi Arabia, where y'all see a lot of fights today. There's a lot of fights going on in Saudi Arabia. But this is the biggest fight that Saudi Arabia had ever seen at the time. Heavyweight championship of the world. Anthony Joshua versus Andy Ruiz 2, the rematch. And I was a part of Michael Hunter's training camp, so we went over there. And the card was stacked, man. It was Philip Hergovich, Michael Hunter, Alexander Povetkin, Maurice Watts, Dillian White, Anthony Joshua, Alexander Usyk. It was a privilege to be there. Definitely a blessing. And Eddie Hearn gave me his time. He gave me time. Drop a comment, like, subscribe. Y'all know it's Team GB. You go, buddy.
Fight hype here with the money man of the sport, Eddie Hearn. How you feeling out here in Saudi, Eddie?
Great, man. I'm excited, nervous.
You made it happen. The haters said it wasn't going to happen.
They said.
The haters said it wasn't going to happen.
The fight won't happen. We're here a couple of days away.
It's beautiful here. It's beautiful here, Eddie.
It's more experience, you know. It's very easy to listen to what people say who've never even been here. Everybody that's here right now is saying, this is great, you know, this is great, hospitality's great. Wait till you see the venue. You know, the opportunities here are endless for boxing. You can't be single-minded. You know, I saw Bob Arum's piece the other day, like, you know, it's on at a really bad time in the US. But there's another world out there, Bob, you know. Don't be so small-minded.
World champion.
Yeah, but it's not just, listen, shows in America are great, shows in the UK are great. Here we have a new region in the Middle East. It could bring so much more excitement, drama and money to fighters, to fans, everything. So embrace it. And I've got to say, from the day we got here, you know, to this day and to Saturday, it's been incredible, you know. It's been an incredible experience. And the vision these people have, all the promises they've delivered, it's just the beginning. But the only thing that matters is getting that victory on Saturday night.
On Saturday night, we know you focus on Joshua and Ruiz. We know, you know, Joshua is your golden ticket. But we want to know, what's your favorite fight on the card that you put together? Because you put together a hell of a card.
That all heavyweight card, great heavyweight fights. The standout for me is Michael Hunter against Alexander Povetkin. I just watched them both working out there.
Do you have a pick?
You know, I think that with the momentum right now, you have to go with Michael Hunter, right? Because he finds a way to win, you know? But what he's going to have to do on Saturday is he's going to have to come through fire because he's up against another guy who's technically good and fast. You know, what Michael's always going to do really well is make slow, big heavyweights look like slow, big heavyweights. Against Alexander Povetkin, who can punch, who has great movement, he's a great amateur as well, Olympic gold medalist. But Michael does have the pressure. He has the belief. You know, and I think the team has the belief they're going to do it. And if he wins, you've got to say he's ready for a shot at the world heavyweight title.
You know? Michael, of course, has history in his corner. He has a two-time heavyweight champion who fought Povetkin. Do you think that that's burning a fire in the Hunter camp? Do you think that that's going to play inside the fight?
Yeah, of course. And, you know, you look at as well, Hasim Rahman has got so much narrative with the main event. You know, he upset the odds many years ago in one of the great upsets of all time as well. So he's been involved in rematches. He's been involved with everything. So there's so much narrative in every fight. But that fight, for me, is going to be a brilliant fight. You know, two world-class heavyweights.
Brilliant card, Eddie. Yeah. Last thing.
When you bring a fight and a show like this to a new territory, the best thing to do is to give them the biggest and the best, and that's the heavyweight division.
Yes, sir. Last thing, in 2020, what can we expect to see from DAZN, and provided that Joshua wins on Saturday, can we expect to see a Ruiz Joshua 3?
I don't know. There's nothing in the contract for another fight, but we're here and we're ready for great fights on DAZN. You know, we've had an unbelievable run with Canelo Kovalev, with Canelo Jacobs, with Gennady Golovkin, with Usyk, KSI Logan Paul fight, and now Joshua Ruiz. We're starting on the schedule for next year. It looks fantastic. And, you know, I believe we're going to see top fights on DAZN next year. Joshua's ready to fight everybody. But all that matters right now is victory on Saturday.
That's it. Well, my name is Hasim Rahman Jr. I would love for you to line up a cruiserweight for me.
Yes,
I can't wait to get one of your cruiserweights or become one of your cruiserweights. I want to thank you for bringing this fight to Saudi, and we thank you at Fight High. Appreciate you, Eddie. Only greats around me get it OG, and it's cold blooded nigga GP. Team Rockman winning nigga team 3. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Niggas just wanna go viral, niggas don't wanna.